Which of the following is the correct graph of the given rational function? We have f of x equals the opposite of the quotient of the product of x plus 4 and x minus 3 and the product of x plus 2 and x minus 2. Let's begin by determining any vertical asymptotes or holes. Recall the holes are the zeros of the denominator that are also zeros of the numerator, and because there are no common factors between the numerator and denominator, there are no holes. And therefore we'll say none. The vertical asymptotes are the zeros of the denominator that are not zeros of the numerator, which means in this case we have two vertical asymptotes. X plus 2 equals 0 when x equals negative 2. X equals negative 2 is one vertical asymptote. X minus 2 is equal to 0 when x equals positive 2. X equals positive 2 is the second vertical asymptote. And it is important to give the vertical asymptotes as equations because they are vertical lines. Let's find the horizontal asymptote last. To determine the x-intercepts, we want to determine the x-values that make f of x equal to 0. A fraction is equal to 0 when the numerator is equal to 0 and the denominator is not. And therefore, we determine the x-intercepts by determining the zeros of the numerator. Well, x plus 4 is equal to 0 when x equals negative 4, which means negative 4 comma 0 is an x-intercept. Again, when x equals 0, the function value will be 0. And then x minus 3 is equal to 0 when x equals 3, which indicates 3 comma 0 is another x-intercept. When x equals 3, the function value will be 0. And now to find the y-intercept, we determine the function value f of 0 because any point on the y-axis has an x-value of 0. So let's go ahead and find f of 0. F of 0 is equal to the opposite of when x is 0, the numerator is 4 times negative 3. The denominator is 2 times negative 2. Simplifying, we have the opposite of negative 12 divided by negative 4, which simplifies to the opposite of 3, or negative 3. The y-intercept is the point 0, comma, negative 3. And now let's determine the horizontal asymptote. To determine the horizontal asymptote, we want to determine the end behavior. Let's find the right-hand behavior, which means when x approaches infinity, what is happening to the function value f of x? There are several ways we can determine the right-hand behavior, which will give us a horizontal asymptote. I'm going to go ahead and multiply the binomial factors together, which gives us f of x equals the opposite of, in the numerator we have x times x, which is x squared, and then minus 3x plus 4x, that's plus x, and then minus 12. In the denominator we have x squared minus 2x plus 2x, that's 0, and then minus 4. One way to determine the horizontal asymptote or end behavior is to compare the degree of the numerator and degree of the denominator. Because both degrees are 2, the horizontal asymptote is equal to the ratio of the leading coefficients, which would give us the opposite of 1 divided by 1, which equals negative 1. This indicates as x approaches infinity, f of x approaches negative 1, and y equals negative 1 is the horizontal asymptote. Another way to find a horizontal asymptote when we have a rational function is to focus only on the term in the numerator with the highest degree and the term in the denominator with the highest degree, and then see what's happening to that related function as x approaches infinity. So if we look at the function y equals the opposite of x squared divided by x squared as x approaches infinity, we'll notice here we can simplify. X squared divided by x squared simplifies to 1, giving us y equals negative 1. And as x approaches infinity, the y value is not affected because there's no variable, which also verifies we have a horizontal asymptote of y equals negative 1. And now let's see if we can select the correct graph. Notice all four graphs do have vertical asymptotes at x equals positive 2 and x equals negative 2. and none of them have holes. Let's see which have a horizontal asymptote of y equals negative 1. Well, notice this first graph does have a horizontal asymptote of y equals negative 1, but the second graph does not. Its horizontal asymptote is y equals positive 1. We can eliminate this graph. Going down to the second row, this first graph also has a horizontal asymptote of y equals 1, not y equals negative 1. We can eliminate this graph. But this last graph does have a horizontal asymptote of y equals negative 1. So now we're down to two options. And now let's look at the x-intercepts. The x-intercepts should be negative 4, comma 0, and 3, comma 0. For the first graph, we do have an x-intercept of negative 4, comma 0, and 3, comma 0. But this last graph does not. The x-intercepts are negative 3, comma 0, and 4, comma 0, which are not correct. This last graph is out. And also notice this first graph does have a y-intercept of 0, comma negative 3. And therefore, this first graph is the correct graph for the given function. I hope you found this helpful.